Hey, how you all doing? We over here at Newbies Grove, and I'm with my moderator over here, Pastor Evans of the Tidewater Peninsula Baptist Association, and my storm team. I mean, they take care of everything. Back when we were at 326 Tabs Lane, we sent like 164,000 pounds of water to Flint, Michigan. I'm talking about, and the building was small. We didn't even have police. We had to cancel certain events and everything because of this team of people right here and the Tidewater Peninsula Baptist Association. They use me as the hub, I guess, because they, even though I ain't young, you know, I'm the youngest one, so I guess they feel like we can move stuff more readily than they can. So they just use my church because I'm one of the vice moderators here. But this is a team effort with all these different churches. And right here we have representing the churches. These are not all of them. We have New Beach Grove Baptist Church. We have Colossian Baptist Church. We have Ebenezer Baptist Church. And we also have Shalom Baptist Church. And these team of people do a phenomenal job. We want to make sure that we take care of the people who are hurting, because we may be hurting one day. In fact, it just was a blessing. Some people were mad at the meteorologists because they were wrong, but I just thank God that they were wrong. Although my heart still goes out for those who were hurt and harmed by the storm. Right now, if you want to send money donations, you can send it to www.newbeachgrove.org/give. It'll be an earmark there to take care of the people from the storm. But you can also mail checks to Tidewater Peninsula Baptist Association. Just mail it to our address, 361 Beachmont Drive, thank you so much, in Newport News, Virginia, 23608. You can mail it directly to us, but put it earmarked at the Tidewater Peninsula Baptist Association, because this is not a church thing. This is a team thing.
I'm Pastor Evans of Colossian Baptist Church, Newport News, Virginia, also the moderator of the Tidewater Peninsula Baptist Association. And our churches have come together in this district to pull some supplies and things together because of Hurricane Florence that hit the coast of North Carolina and South Carolina and left devastation in its path, and family members lost homes, and some of them even lost some of their relatives in the process. But we come to let them know that we are concerned about them as a church family. For the Bible tells us in Matthew 25 that we need to take care of those who are less fortunate, take care of those who are in prison, take care of those who are sick. And so we come to do what the Bible has instructed us to do, and to reach out to those who are less fortunate than us. And we are trying to do everything we can to ensure that we lift their spirits and to ensure them that God's love and grace is with them through this process that they're going through from Hurricane Florence.
Greetings, Hampton Roads. This is Pat Johnson. I'm representing the Tidewater Peninsula Baptist Association that is comprised of churches throughout the area, on the north, on the south side, and on the peninsula. And we're here today to plead for support for those survivors of Hurricane Florence, because they are in desperate need, mostly right now food. We will be taking other types of items, but right now the critical immediate need is food. And so we're asking you to please do your best gifts, your best offerings, because but for the grace of God, it could have been us. We could be underwater. So we're asking you please to talk to your neighbors, your friends, your church members, get your youth involved so that all of them know how critical this is, because we've gotten word today that all of the stores, Walmart, all the stores in the area in the Carolinas, the shelves are bare. So what we can get to them now is a critical need.
My name is Dwight Benton. I'm the Tidewater Peninsula Baptist Association Home Mission Ministry Director. And we have been blessed again this year to have this nice facility that we're going to be receiving supplies for our victims down in North and South Carolina again this year. We've been blessed with this large size room to receive all of the items that's going to be required. And I have a list of specific items that are in immediate need. All the shelves and food items in North Carolina in the flooded areas, shelves are bare. So we're asking for all that can, and do what you can do to help us take care of our less fortunate sisters and brothers in North and South Carolina. I have a specific list of supplies, food, in specific, that's in immediate need. Food supplies, all non-perishable food supplies, and we also want to take care of our infants, our babies, and with clothing and food, for those that have been displaced by the hurricane. And we will be receiving those items here at New Beach Grove on 361 Beachmont Drive here in Newport News, starting today through 5 p.m. On this time next Wednesday on the 26th of September. Please do what you can to bring all the supplies that you can. And please, let's bless our less fortunate the way God has blessed each of you. And we look forward to working with all of you in this endeavor.
If you look around, this is a huge area. This is a huge area. This room is just going to be designated for those who are in need. So bring it in, pack it out. We want to send 2, 3, 4, 5 big rig trucks out to North Carolina and South Carolina. We already have churches that are earmarked. Now, you know people are hurting when they say, don't even send us money. They said send us food because the money means nothing because there's nothing on the shelves. Now, I know you're going to ask, how in the world are they going to get it there? Because streets are open to rescue vehicles, only to rescue vehicles that are coming to provide aid for individuals. So our trucks will be marked as aid relief vehicles, and they will be allowed to go through Route 241. To get to where the victims are. So it will get there. We have two pastors that we're working with right now. So we also want to just thank the mayor of the city for making sure Mayor Price and our city manager, Cindy Roth, and all of our city council members, because they are going to cover the transportation. They have given us a check to cover the trucks to go out to these places. Isn't it great when you have God-fearing people in power in your city? Because we have resources, but we don't have unlimited resources. But when we begin to bring our political and our public service together to work along with our organizations like the Tidewater Peninsula Baptist Association, that is great. I love Newport News. We're going to make sure that we help everyone. Bring whatever you can bring, even if it's not diapers, even if it's not food. If you want to bring clothes, bring them. They're not asking for that because right now they just want the bare necessities. But whatever you bring is welcome, all right? Now I'm going to just go ahead and speak in the words of Sister Benton. If you're going to bring clothes, bring some new clothes or gently worn clothes, all right? Don't bring us nothing you don't want, amen? Well, nothing you wouldn't wear, all right? All right, so that's all we want to say, and we just thank you so much for partnering with us, and I'm sure there's going to be some information on the bottom of your screen that you can read to know exactly what you can do in order to partner with us.